This video will be about what is new in the latest Home Assistant 2023.4, and it will be a quick, dirty and to the point from start till the very end. A summary: in this release, there are some new dialogs, new features of the tile card, some advanced templating functions are also added, new blueprint selectors, and last but not least, some database optimizations, as well as a bunch of other noteworthy changes and a lot of small breaking changes. The first new thing that I'm going to talk about are the new dialogs. For example, a local alarm card, which is now looking like a switch, and it is way more cleaner than before with no visible keypad. But don't worry, the keypad will be automatically shown only when it is needed. And if you want to know more about how to make your own local alarm system thanks to Home Assistant, please check my dedicated video about that topic, which I'll link in your upper right corner. Same switch-alike facelift is also happened to the cover cards. So if you have covers integrated in your Home Assistant, like a garage doors, window shades, or any other covers, you can now make them look like a switch and control them that way. Tilting is also supported. In such a case, a second slider is shown. The first one will control the open and close position, and the second one will show how much of a tilt has been applied. Fans are also getting this new look, so if you have fans, you can test by yourself. The same features that we saw so far are also added in tile cards, so you can have a nice, consistent look on your whole Home Assistant dashboard. If you add an alarm tile card, for example, it will look as a smaller copy of the normal cards. You can also hide or show the alarm modes on the tile card, which is also a nice feature. In general, I like these changes, especially if I look these cards on a mobile phone. But can you please share what is your opinion in the comments below? Do you like this new look or not? The next feature in Home Assistant 2023.4 is macros for templates, which means you can define your own function with your own logic, and you can reuse that on multiple places in Home Assistant. A new folder for that purpose will now be dedicated in the Home Assistant structure, where these macros will be stored. The files inside will have a .jinja extension, and they have to have some logic written in Jinja, template engine for Python. That is because Home Assistant is powered by the Jinja 2 templating engine. In other words, Home Assistant is using Jinja syntax for templates. So, once this macro is defined, it can be called anywhere in Home Assistant. If you are an advanced Home Assistant user, this feature should be quite interesting for you. Otherwise, you can freely skip it and continue using the Home Assistant the same way you did before. And if you are not a Home Assistant user at all, what are you still waiting for? Go and get one and start playing. If you are unsure how to get started, then register for my upcoming webinar, where I'll talk about the official installation types of Home Assistant and their pros and cons. And if you want to test the waters fast and safe, there will be something for you on that webinar as well. I'll show you how to run Home Assistant on a PC in under 5 minutes. So, reserve your spot on my webinar right now for free on my website automatelike.pro/webinar. And now some more templating in Home Assistant 2023.4, starting with the new is hidden entity function, which can tell if an entity has been marked as hidden or not. And as shown in Home Assistant documentation, this function can be applied to a whole Home Assistant area and can return all of the entities that are not hidden in this area. And when we talk about areas, there is a new area function, which will simply list all of the areas that you have configured in your Home Assistant installation. Something else interested added in this latest release is break and continue for for loops support, which makes the for loops more agile, and this functionality is now quite the same as in any modern programming language. HasValue is the next new function added, and this can be used as a quick test if an entity has a valid value, or it is unavailable or in unknown state. The next new thing will probably stay hidden for most of us, because the changes are mainly done under the hood, or to be precise, in the Home Assistant database. The biggest takeaway from all this work is that the Home Assistant database running on SQLite is now even more optimized and faster than ever before. As a result, we should experience quicker response times, faster startup, reduced CPU and disk I/O usage, all of that on less disk space because deduplication is now enabled. For the Blueprint's creators, there is a new constant selector now that provides a fixed value or doesn't provide anything at all. Also, you can now pass a list of filters in the selectors, and before Home Assistant 2023.4, you can only filter with a single set of conditions. If some of the terms that I'm using are not so clear for you, make sure that you download my smart home glossary available on my website automatelike.pro/glossary. It's totally free. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill, and I'll see you next week.